हेलो ट्वेल्थ क्लास, दिस इज़ योर लेक्चर 3 ऑफ चैप्टर कंप्यूटर नेटवर्क्स पार्ट 1। सो टॉपिक्स ऑफ टुडेज क्लास आर, फर्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट नेटवर्क डिवाइसेस और हार्डवेयर, देन व्हाट इज क्लाउड, देन इंटरनेट ऑफ थिंग्स। नाउ इन नेटवर्क डिवाइसेस यू हैव द फॉलोइंग टॉपिक्स, दैट इज हब, स्विच, गेटवे, रिपीटर एंड राउटर। So first, what is hub? So hub is basically a broadcast device which connects several computers together. You can see in this image, this is a hub. Okay, in this many ports are there. So when you put any particular device in it, so it will get connected. It cannot handle the network traffic. Message is delivered from one computer to rest of all computer. That is known as broadcasting. In a hub, ports are there which are used to connect NIC of the computer. Okay, you know what is NIC? That is network interface card. So this is your hub. Next is switch. So switch is a type of hub. It connects a filter which filters the data before sending, and it is then directed to the intended node only. So this hub is an intelligent hub. You can see the port is here. Okay, you have to, when you want to insert the switch, then you have to insert the particular device on the switch. Okay, so this is the image of this switch. Next is repeater. So repeater is a device which accepts the weak signals and amplifies the signals for further broadcasting. With the use of it, the signal length get increases, and it is also known as the amplifier. So this is the image of repeater. If your signal is weak, then if you put the repeater, then the signal that is generated with a high speed. Okay, you can see in this image here the signals is very low, and when you inserted the repeater, then the signal are at the same frequency. Okay, so this is the repeater. Next is your gateway. So gateway, when two or more the network that uses the different hardware and software, then we use the gateway to make the coordination between them. So it converts the one network language into the another network language so that they can communicate. In this you can see, this is a server of different network and you have put it here a gateway. Okay, and with this gateway, this all the computers are get connected and interconnected to each other. You can see this has a different IP address and this system has a different IP address, and this one is the gateway. Next is your router. So router, that is also a networking device that send data packets from source machine to destination machine. It will take the shortest path, which path is suitable for this to transfer the data, and this on the OSI model, this works on the third layer, that is it works on the network layer, because we are talking about the networking, so it will work on the network layer. You can see this internet working and the routing. This is a modem. Here you have used the router A, this is a router B, and this is router C. So it will just send the data from the source machine to the destination machine. Okay, so this is a back of the router. This port is for the LAN and this is for the WAN. Now next topic is cloud computing. You might heard about cloud. So the cloud, that is internet based computing, where you can share the resources, software and any information. Okay, for example, your electricity grid. Now next is, it is a kind of distributed data processing technique. Cloud computing is a style of computing in which dynamically scalable and often virtual resources are made available as a services over the internet. So in cloud, whatever the data you have stored on the any cloud, then you can easily access that data at any time. But the condition is you have an internet connection to accessing that data. So advantages, less investment. So any work can be initiated on less or the zero balance. Maintenance is also less expensive. high speed. The cloud computing can provide the required resources in less time. Reliability. It is provided by reliable companies, organization. Hence, it is very reliable. Scalability. Its capacity can be purchased as per your fluctuating requirements. Environment support. So, cloud save the energy as well as minimize the carbon excretion. Disadvantages. Online privacy and security is not safe in it. You cannot access your data without internet. Now, cloud computing. It is of four types. That is private clouds, public clouds, community clouds and hybrid clouds. So, first is the private clouds. As the name suggests, private. So, it is just restricted only for the single organization. So, these are the clouds for exclusive use by a single organization and typically controlled or managed and hosted in the private data centers. So, the hosting and the operation of private clouds that may also be outsourced to a third-party service provider. Okay, but the private cloud that remain exclusive only for the use of the one organization. Next is public clouds. So these are the clouds for use by multiple organizations on a shared basis and hosted and managed by a third party service provider. So these are the example of public cloud that are the Google Drive. You already know about Google Drive, Amazon Cloud Drive, etc. Next is your community clouds. So these are the clouds for use by a group of related organizations who wish to make use of a common cloud computing environment. Okay, if you want to use any common computing environment, then you have to use the community clouds. Hybrid clouds. So in this, private and public clouds are used. So the organization adopts both the private and the public cloud for a single application in order to take advantage of the benefits of both. So these four are the types of cloud. Mainly private and public clouds are used. Now the next topic is Internet of Things. So Internet, it is a network of the physical objects. Okay, anything that is connected with Internet is of Internet of Things. So this IoT enables the interconnection by the Internet of computing devices embedded in everyday objects that enabling them to send and receive the data. Or in easy language, we can say that all the things that are connected to Internet are called Internet of Things. So the word thing that will always refer to the smart devices that connect to form the IoT. Its components are the sensors, connectivity, people and the processes. Now, in Internet of Things, there are some technologies that enable it. The first is the RFID, radio frequency identification. Then sensors. Then smart technologies. Then software. Then the efficient network connectivity. Now the first one is RFID, that is radio frequency identification. So this technology is designed to use the radio waves to read and capture information stored on a tag that is called an RFID tag. You all might be aware about this but do not know about the term, that is RFID. So an RFID tag is a small microchip that attached to an antenna. So it identifies and tracks the data of the things. Sensors, you already aware about the sensor. So the sensor is a device that able to detect changes in an environment. A sensor is able to measure a physical phenomenon like temperature, pressure and so on that transform it into an electric signal. The sensors enable us to collect data about the status of the thing. So modern age IoTs contain different type of sensors for variety of applications. Most common types of sensor that use in IoT are temperature sensor, proximity sensor, pressure sensor, optical sensor, humidity sensor, motion detection sensor, smoke sensors, gas sensor and many other types. Next is smart technologies. So you already aware about this also, smart technologies. So smart technology that include the additional functionality to take action and have other processing capabilities as per the requirements. For example, the smart controllers can connect with the smart devices and act upon them. also as per the need of the hour, that is turning off or on a device, stopping a device, then stopping a vehicle, looking, unlocking a door, adjusting the temperature of an oven, and many more such actions. The smart technologies of IoT are able to interact with the smart nano devices as well. Now next is software. So the software is equally important in the success of any technologies. The software provide the reusable solutions for connecting, taking action and solving issues that may arise. Next is the efficient network connectivity. So it will just internet, that is also very important. So you have to good internet connect for accessing these things, you have a good internet connection for connecting all these things. Now next is devices that can form the IoT. You can see in this diagram. So in this picture, this smart cities, that is water distribution, then waste management with the help of the IoT. Okay, this is the energy engagement, this is the grid automation, wireless grid automation. Here in wearable, that is smart watches, fitness and the activity monitor. Okay, these all are the devices. Home appliances like refrigerator, coffee maker, air conditioner, water heater. And in agriculture, smart farming, crop monitoring, climate monitoring and forecasting. And in cars, that is automotive cars, engine management. Okay, so these all are the devices that can use the IoT. Next is your homework. So first question is, you have to write in details about the network devices. Write the name of the device, then you have to explain. Then what is cloud, and you have to explain its types. Then you have to write notes on Internet of Things. Okay, so this is your homework. So thank you and have a nice day.